That adorable little sound signifies a correct answer when students practice a subject on khanacademy.org, a website started several years ago as a way for Sal Khan to help tutor a relative.
Khan Academy has grown since then to be this huge free online platform where students can learn and practice a lot of different subjects.
Melissa Hernandez uses Khan Academy to practice for the college entrance exam, the SAT.
I use Khan Academy about 2 days or 3 days before the November SAT, and my math went up 50 points.
She's not alone. A recent report revealed students who use Khan Academy for 20 hours to prepare for the SAT could see scores increase an average of 115 points. One reason? A partnership with the College Board, creators of the SAT, allowing students to voluntarily link their PSAT and SAT scores to Khan Academy.
The Khan Academy has an SAT practice platform that takes students' actual results and scores and individualizes the practice for students based on those scores.
Khan Academy also has individually tailored exercises in multiple languages for students in kindergarten through college.
Because this is personalized, you're not wasting your time practicing things that you don't really need to practice. It's really targeted based on your own results, and it adapts as you practice.
Personalized exercises, instructional videos, and available hints are the main reasons math teacher and father Delvin Scott uses Khan Academy with his students and family.
It's almost like having a teacher in your home going through the steps. You can pause, you can rewind, you can take your time in it so you're not hurried and you can actually get through it and make sure you understand the concept before moving on.
The best part, the exercises are fun.
You know, you'd think they'd be boring, but they're not.
You can find the Khan Academy by going to palmbeachschools.org. Look for the district's link drop-down menu in the upper left and drag down to Learning Tools. Find your grade level and explore all the free resources available. Tricia Shervin, reporting for the Education Network, keeping you informed.